Arturo, LeBron, Tapia, Dineno, these are just a few players who have set tears of emotion in this tournament. And that is because Valladolid has been the most thrilling tournament in recent months. But what did Coello feel in the most special tournament for him? Hi everyone, I'm Pablo and I welcome you to a new Forset. Before we get started, I got Tapia's new racket for 2025 here, so if you wanna be the first one to see it, make sure to subscribe to the channel now. And before analyzing the big final in Valladolid, let's talk about LeBron and Dineno. Because they were really close to losing in the second round against Guerrero Bautista. The match got complicated and we saw a very interesting moment with LeBron and Cilingo. Think that Cilingo has only been coaching LeBron and Dineno for 3 tournaments, and in my opinion, the way he handled the situation was perfect.
Ya te lo dije, vos sos parte del equipo, vos lo tenés ganado, en vez de encerrarte con cara de ojete, porque el campo no sabe qué poronga te pasa, sabe que estás enojado, pero no sabe qué poronga te pasa. Escuchame una cosa. Agarrá y decíselo, Juan, te lo pido por favor. Necesito que rompan esta barrera de.
¿Se lo he dicho?
Bien, boludo. Bien, pero ahí, cuando empieza a pasar otra vez, vos tenés que acercarte
al plato. Otra vez, bien.
Sí, tranquilo, dale.
Tranquilo.
Bien. Entonces, en el 15-30, vos tenés que hacer es decir, tengo la concha de tu hermana, tranquilo, boludo, vamos a jugar así. Sí, Juan, porque sos la parte del equipo, no hace falta que salgan de acá y vos te encierres allá con cara de ojete. Sí, boludo, lo podés decir, porque es responsabilidad tuya, porque es tu compañero.
Y en parte del equipo,
no te vas a pelear, Juan. Este plato es imposible pelearse, Juan.
He highlights something I find to be very true, that is almost impossible for Martín to get angry. But the most impactful moment wasn't in that match. LeBron and Dineno move on to the quarterfinals against Edu Alonso and Momo González, where LeBron will end the match like this. But what happened to El Lobo that moved him so much? Well, at the beginning of the second set, after a winning smash from Juan, someone in the crowd started chanting Ale Galán's name. So Juan stopped the match and asked the referee to calm things down. And at the end of the match, Martín Dineno gave us one of the tournament's most beautiful moments.
No sé quién fue la persona que dijo lo que dijo hace una media hora atrás. Entiendan que nosotros también sentimos, la pasamos mal. No es tan divertido eso, por más que para mucha gente lo sea. Simplemente respeten, y también respeten a Juan. Tienen acá a uno de los mejores jugadores de la historia, seguramente, y no solo por mí y porque sea mi compañero, sino porque muchos lo pueden decir. Disfrútenlo, quiéranlo, denle cariño, es un fenómeno. A veces, tal vez no tiene las mejores maneras, pero créanme que es un divino y ojalá muchos lo puedan conocer como yo, así que nada, simplemente eso.
Well, I honestly completely agree with everything Dineno said. Because LeBron might be some people's favorite player and not others, but insulting a player for doing his job, like what happened the other day in Valladolid, was not right. I actually fear this could start to be like football, where fans will shout Cristiano to Messi and vice versa. But beyond that moment, they made it to another semi-final against Coello and Tapia. And that was the second time these players had faced off, but this time there was no doubt. Coello and Tapia's level was far superior. And in fact, we saw something very unusual. Dineno made more unforced errors than winners. But there are several reasons to explain that stat. And obviously, first is that Coello and Tapia were extraordinary. Just Tapia had 20 winners and only 2 unforced errors, that means an almost perfect match. And second, in Valladolid, hitting a good lob is really tough, and according to Padel Intelligence, only 14% of shots were lobs compared to a 23% average. And of all the lobs, 61% were smashed compared to the 56% average. So, in other words, there are fewer lobs and more of them are smashed. That this is the worst case scenario for players like Dineno and Chingoto. Actually, Fede Chingoto explained in a press conference how hard it is for him to play in Valladolid.
La clara cosa que se ve en la pista es que está buena. Entonces, es verdad que a beneficio me ayuda un poco en la pegada a mí, que es una falencia mía, y capaz que me puedo poner un poco agresivo. En contra es que si la traen en la, pista intermedia lenta. Acá no tengo ni un hueco para conectar el globo, lo tengo que meter en el último milímetro para que no sea winner.
Well, another bird that didn't have the best feeling in Valladolid was Tupayanguas, because for the second time they lost to Sbri Bergamini in what will be their last tournament together. But this time the defeat was in the round of 16, their worst result since they team up. And honestly, I'm starting to have doubts about the viability of the Tupayanguas project based on how they complement each other on the court. In fact, the former pair of Garrido Yanguas isn't doing well on their own. The pair that was the fourth best of the year split up and neither has had better results. Additionally, Garrido and Alex Ruiz ended their partnership after losing in this tournament to Los Bombarderos Augsburger Chozas. You probably knew it, but Garrido will play in Paris with Bergamini, a duo I find quite interesting. But Garrido and Alex Ruiz conquerors in Valladolid, Chozas, Augsburger are on fire. They face Chingalán again in the quarterfinals in a very tough match. And honestly, I didn't think Chingalán were such favorites in that match considering the conditions in Valladolid. But without a doubt, Galán was the MVP because he was the player with the most winners and the fewest unforced errors in the entire match. But even with the loss to Chingalán, I'm opening the most important debate right now. Because the World Cup is around the corner and the roster might be announced this week. And in my opinion, right now, there are 4 guaranteed players for Argentina: Tapia, Chingotto, Dineno and Stupa. So, if you were the Argentinian coach, which other 4 players would you select? And the same happens with Spain, because Cuello, Galán, and LeBron and Paquito are locked in. So, same question, if you were the Spain coach, which other 4 players would you take to the World Cup? Anyway, beyond the World Cup, Chingalán made it to another semi-final, but this time against Paquito and Cardona. The result was the same, but the feelings were different. Because Paquito and Cardona are getting closer to the top 2 pairs, but there is still a way to go. Think that Chingalán had 11 break points and Paquito Cardona had none. And who hit fewer smashes? Because you probably think Chingotto, but he wasn't, because he smashed 10 times with 100% efficiency. Actually, it was Paquito with just 9 smashes and only 13 winners in total during the entire match. But obviously, Cardona is the one responsible for winning more points in that pair, but for now, it's not enough to hurt the best pairs in the world. Best pairs in the world that once again will meet in another final. The 12th match between them, with Coelho and Tapia leading the head-to-head 6-5. And after not feeling their best in Madrid and Rotterdam, how would Galán perform? Well, he didn't start the match well, as the performance graph shows. But little by little, Galán raised his level, winning many net duels against Tapia and Coelho. While at the same time, Chingotto struggled the most with 17 unforced errors. That is something very strange for him. But like Dineno, he was severely affected by not being able to hit the lob. Also, Coelho started to look a bit nervous at the beginning of the third set, but then an extraordinary Tapia appeared. And for me, the key was that they volleyed more and better, that Chingalán closed enough spaces and being more aggressive. So this way they claimed their 4th consecutive title, which adds extra pressure on Chingalán heading into the Paris Major. Because in fact, the difference in the race now is 2,100 points. This gives a big advantage to the number ones and leaves Galán with the last changes if he wants to be number one this season. But when the time came for Arturo and Agustín to speak after their win, we were all speechless.
Quería decir algo muy 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 especial para mí, que es difícil que lo diga, pero no se lo he dicho a nadie porque no quería agafarlo. Para mí era muy importante. Hace 2 años y medio falleció mi abuelo. Yo un día por la Plaza Mayor. Le dije, estaba montado, le dije, abuelo, yo voy a ganar este torneo y te lo voy a dedicar. No ha podido ser en vida, pero espero que desde donde esté ahí arriba lo haya podido disfrutar. Llevo literalmente 2 años y medio sin decírselo a nadie, por si acaso se llegaba a este momento poder decirlo y poder dedicárselo a él, porque lo quiero mucho, lo he hecho mucho de menos y nada, bueno, este torneo es para ti.
Honestly, I'm convinced Arturo, grandfather, would be proud of him, not just for winning, but for the kind of athlete he is. And I can't think of a better way to end this video than with Arturo's words, so thank you so much for watching it, and see you in the next one. Chao.